What is objective-based planning? Be aware that justifying the added cost of smart devices can be an issue, okay? Especially if you're early on in experimentation and you haven't really proven things out yet. That's just reality. So you may have to get a little creative. That's the fun part. And you can start building a smart device solution around a functional problem. Because guess what? If you solve that problem with a smart device solution, you just won some advocates and you'll start really moving it forward. So how do you do a lot of that? It starts with objectives, okay? The single greatest hurdle to the adoption of smart manufacturing may be the absence of information and goals. Manufacturers, you guys do a great job of promoting the network and the devices and technology, but what is the end goal that we're trying to realize? You know, the concept of progression enables us to get started on the path without necessarily having the big picture, you know, in front of us at all times. So at some point, we got to start turning that data into valuable information. And that's where that information plan can help. And information planning can be packaged around small objectives as you're stepping into progression. It really is that simple. So think about it. A couple questions I'm going to pose to you. What is your team trying to accomplish? What metrics are you trying to impact? If you can get clarity just on those two, what are you trying to accomplish? What metrics are you trying to impact? That's going to put you so much further ahead than most people. It's going to also create a lot of alignment. Always be thinking a few levels up, okay? Think about the OEE metric that so many industries use out there, right? The measure performance of how the plant's doing. And think about the cascading objectives that affect OEE. So if I'm trying to figure out how the decisions at the machine or device level impact OEE, start thinking about, well, how can I start measuring at that level to really report up to that OEE, right? And if you make that connection and you start your experimentation there, next thing you know, it's all going to start clicking together, okay? So narrow your focus to a more contained process, and that's going to really help you zone in. And then as you learn those lessons, guess what? You're in a position to scale like no other. Because you had that experimentation. You're confident in what you did. You know it works. And you'll be able to take that on to the next step of the journey. So it all starts with clarifying the objectives. And that's going to really help drive your planning in the future.